all the time.
God is good.
Before we begin, let's sign ourselves. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
I request you all to just close your eyes, children, and sit in your places. And just close your eyes for 2 minutes. And just thank the Lord for every blessing. For the blessing that we are all together online. And for the gift of life, for the gift of faith, for His love, for every blessing in our life, for the parents and whatever we have. Just thank the Lord for 2 minutes. Let's close our eyes. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you,
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Jesus. Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We glorify
Hallelujah.
Your name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. We praise you. We praise you.
Once again, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, my dear children, so we'll play a short game. So we'll firstly, last time we had played this game. So it's like Simon says, and we have to do that work. Okay. So Simon says, firstly, stand up. And Simon says, wish one another. Maybe y'all can wish each other online only. Praise the Lord and peace be with you. Okay. Like same here.
Peace be with you.
Okay. Okay. Simon says, raise your hand and clap your hands. Okay. Simon says, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Okay. So God has blessed us with the gift of faith and love and joy and peace. So we take this simple song. I do my thing so y'all know this action. It is very easy. Because normally we take this song, who gives the faith for the Fafa faith? Okay. So I want each and every children to sing and dance with us, okay? Let's clap our hands.
As we clap, let's also move in our places. Let's not sit. Let's stand and together we will sing this song.
Who gives the faith for the far faith? Who gives the love for the love? Who gives the hope for the hope? And who gives the grace for the grace? Who gives the faith for the faith? Who gives the love for the love? Who gives the hope for the hope? And who gives the grace for the grace? Who is that man? I want to shake his hand, for he lives in me, and he died for you and me. Dip, dip, da da da, dip, dip, da da da, dip, dip, da da da, dip,
dip, dip, da da da, dip, dip, da da da, dip, dip, da da da, dip, dip, da. Who gives the faith for the faith? Who gives the love for the love? Who gives the hope for the hope? Who gives the grace for the grace? Who is that man? I want to shake his hand, for he lives in me, and he died for you. Dip, dip, da-da-da-dip, dip, da-da-da-dip, dip, 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 dip
mighty hand to the Lord. Actually, Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time, Lord. Lord, even as this time you have given us, Lord, we give away all our sorrows into your hand, whatever pain, whatever struggles we are going in our studies, whatever we are not able to come out from our houses, or whatever struggle and whatever things which are going in our hearts and our minds, we lift up into your hand, O Lord. And we joyfully sing this song that I am trading my sorrows into your hand. I am trading my pain into your hand. Lord, we lift up everything into your hand. We take this song, I'm trading my sorrows. Let's clap, children.
Move in the places.
Come on, move, children. And keep your videos on. I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
I'm trading my sickness, and I'm trading my shame, and I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. You say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen.
Jesus, the Lord, hallelujah. Very good, children. I can see you all dancing. Very good. Are you all doing this for me or for your parents, for anyone? No, we are doing it for Jesus. And Jesus will be very, very happy to see you all dancing and moving for him. Right? So now we take this song, I Love Bananas. You know, the bananas are sweet, the apples are sweet, mangoes are very, very sweet. But above everything, there is something very sweetest. What is that? Love of God, right? The love of God is very, very sweet. It never changes and it is new every morning, right? It is fresh, the love of God. So we take this song. Carol will show you all the actions. Okay, so y'all can go with her. Okay, we'll take this song, I Love Bananas.
I love bananas. I know that mangoes are sweet. I love papayas. Woo! I know that nothing can be the sweet, sweet love of God. I love bananas. I know the mangoes are sweet. I love papayas. I know that nothing can be the sweet, sweet love of God.
Cause
they are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness.
Watch it, yeah.
Mangoes are sweet, I love papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet, sweet love of God.
One more time. I love bananas.
Mangoes are sweet, I love papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet, sweet love of God. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy
faithfulness. I
love bananas. I know the mangoes are sweet. I love papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet, sweet love of God. I love bananas. I know the mangoes are sweet. I love papayas. Nothing can beat the sweet, sweet love of God. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. And I'll praise you with all of my life. My strength, with all of my life, with all of my strength, all of my hope is in you.
Lord, praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you for your love, Lord. Praise
Jesus,
you.
Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Worship your name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. I request all the children to close your eyes. And even as today, we are going to learn about the Abel's offering. What can we give the smallest thing to the Lord? Is our obedience to our parents, faithfulness towards Him, and to share the little things which we have in our lives, the smallest thing which we can share. I want every children to close your eyes and keep your palm open so that even as we take this song, Lord, I offer my life. Over this place, Holy Spirit, we invite you in our hearts, in our minds, in our entire being. You be with us. Also surrender the talk into your hand. Everything must be led by your Spirit, Lord. I surrender every children into your hand. Holy Spirit, we invite you. We take this song. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Children, let's close our eyes.
Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. And fill us with your power. Live inside of me. Welcome, Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. And fill us with your power. Live inside of me. 'Cause you're the living water. The never drying fountain, comforter and counselor, and take complete control. You're the living water. Never drying fountain, comforter and counselor, take complete control. Welcome, Holy Spirit, we are in your presence. Fill us with your power. Live inside of me. Hallelujah.
Worship your holy name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. You are the true vine, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Praise you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. And all God's people says, Amen. Amen. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. So, children, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. And you all are enjoying, and your studies are going good. Okay, so today we have a very interesting topic, okay? That is Abel's offering, okay? So we have an interesting topic that is Abel's offering. Last time we studied on which hero? Any idea? Just type it on your chat box.
Abraham.
Which hero did we study the last time? I will tell you very frequently to use your chat box, okay? So be there and keep typing, okay? So Abraham, so someone said Abraham, good. So we studied about Abraham last time. And today we are going to see on Abel's offering. Even before we could get into little details about Abel's offering, okay? I have something for you over here, okay? We all go to someone's birthday, okay? Just imagine it is your best friend's birthday here today, Okay, it is your best friend's birthday and he has invited you for his birthday. So what is the important thing that you have to do for his birthday? What is the important thing that you have to do for his birthday? Okay, anything that is important that you need to do? It's your best friend's birthday. Yes. Okay. So someone said gifts over here. Okay. You need to prepare. Okay. You need to think, what gift are you going to give your best friend? Okay. So I have some images over here. Just think it is your best friend. Okay. So Alicia will just help me with the presentation over here. Okay. So the first image over here. Okay. If you all see the image, okay, it is of a Superman, okay? The gift, the toy of a Superman, okay? So which Superman gift would you give him? The broken one or the nice one? Which one would you give?
Nice one.
Nice one. Very good. Okay? The next image over here. Okay? This is an image of a cake. Suppose if you have to go to your friend's birthday and you have to give him a cake. Which cake would you give him? The cake that is already eaten up, or the cake that is fully prepared? The full cake. Very good. Okay. So in a similar way, okay, God is a God who is our Father. Okay. And when we have to offer him, what we need to give him? We need to give him the best. We need to give him the best. Okay. So now comes here the story of two brothers. Okay, Cain and Abel. Okay, who are the parents of Cain and Abel? Who are the parents of Cain and Abel? Just type it out over there.
Adam.
Who is the mommy and daddy of Cain and Abel? Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve.
Adam and Eve.
We all know. Okay, so Adam and Eve, they had two children, that is Cain and Abel. And Cain and Abel were good brothers, okay? They were brothers. And when Cain grew up, he became a farmer, okay? So he used to plant trees, he used to plant fruits, he used to plant vegetables. Whereas Abel grew up to become a shepherd, okay? He became a shepherd. Huh? Now, one day it so happened that they had to make an offering to God. What they had to do? They had to make an offering to God. Similarly, like how you had to go to your friend's birthday and offer him something. Okay. So they had to make an offering to God. And that offering was, when Cain had to make an offering, he bought fruits, vegetables, which were not so good. Okay. He thought that it will be okay if I give fruits, vegetables, fruit grains, which are not good to God. Okay. Then Abel offered. What did Abel offer? Abel offered the best sheep to God. The best sheep. The one that was newly born. Okay. He offered that sheep to God. Okay. And when they offered to God, can you tell me which offering was God happy with? Was God happy with Cain's vegetables, which were not so good? Or was God happy with Abel's sheep that he offered? Can you tell me? Type in a chat box. Abel's sheep. Okay, why do you think God was happy with Abel's sheep? Type. Why do you think God was happy with Abel's sheep? I told something, right? About the offering. Yes, because Abel offered the best. Okay, he offered the best. Okay, now if you see, there's one scripture over here from the book of Hebrews. Okay, there is one scripture over here from the book of Hebrews wherein it says, by faith, Abel offered to God a better sacrifice, okay, than Cain, through which he obtained a testimony that he was righteous, okay? So in God's eyes, Abel offered the best sacrifice. And that is how he is remembered. And that is how he is remembered. Okay. Can you think? Okay. Now I'll ask you all to think. Okay. What can you offer to God? What can you offer to God? What is the best gift that God wants from you? Come on, type. Okay, God wants sheep, someone said, like how Abel offered. So I don't know how are you going to get a sheep to God. Okay, what else? Us, okay?
Prayer and love. Us.
What else? Come on, quickly.
Prayer and love.
No answer? Type, type. Faith, okay. Best, okay. What else? What is the gift that you have? What God wants from you? What is the gift that God wants from you? Our obedience. Okay. So over here, God wants the best of you. Okay. God wants you as his best offering. Okay. God wants you as his best offering. Because God loves you. Okay. He has created you in his own image and likeness. And when he created you, he said that you are mine. He has written your name on the palm of his hand. If you look at the creation story, okay? If you look at the creation story, God created you in his own image and likeness, okay? God breathed his breath into you. That is what makes you special. When he created the earth, okay, whatever things on the earth, he said that let there be this light, let there be animals, let there be trees, let there be water, all these things he said. But when it came to creating you and me, okay, what did God do? God, he took some clay, okay, the mud, and he himself formed the thing. He did not say, let there be man, let there be boy, let there be woman, let there be a girl, but he formed. And when he formed, he took care of every details. That is your hair, that is your ears, that is your mouth, that is your lips, that is your eyes, that is your legs, okay? He has taken every details, okay? And he has made you perfect in his image and likeness. That is how God, that is how much God loves you. He has taken a lot of interest in creating you, okay? Suppose if your teacher tells you to paint something, okay? Okay, if your teacher tells you to paint something, okay, you will take a lot of care when you are painting. You will see to it that there's no extra line over here, there's no extra curve over here. Okay, if it is untidy, you all will rub it out. You all will make a perfect drawing and give it to your teacher so that you receive an appreciation from your teacher. So the teacher, when she looks at your drawing, she says, "Arey, wow, what a drawing it is." So this is how much God loves you, okay? This is the story of creation, how much God loves you and loves me. And his love is endless. And that is what he expects you to give him, and that is yourself. And he wants the best of yourself. He doesn't want something that is wasted, something that you're not doing. He wants the best of you, okay? So we will see.
Yes.
What is the best? Okay. Even before we could see what is the best, let us just see one quote over here. Okay. So what it says over here, that what you are is God's gift to you. Now currently, what you are, you have the breath of life. Okay, you are living. Okay, that is God's gift to you. Okay, if you see, everything has been closed now. Okay, there has been lockdown. There are many people who haven't got any food to eat. There are many people who haven't got water to drink. There are many people who haven't got money. But yet, you are there living here. in this difficult moments. Okay, there are many people who have passed away because of this coronavirus, but you are there here, you are living here. That is God's gift to you. Okay, and what you become now, from now on, what you become is your gift to God. Okay, God has gifted you this beautiful life, and what you make of this life will be your gift to God. Okay, so we will go to the next slide. So how can I be the best offering? Since God wants us to be his best offering, how can I be the best offering? Okay. So I have just made a small abbreviation over here. Okay. B-E-S-T. Okay. And there are certain things over here. And I hope after me just sharing this, you all will remember what I shared. Okay. So what is B? B is be loving. Okay. God wants the best of you. Okay. How are you going to present your offering to God? Okay. You need to be the best. So first is B. That is be loving. Okay. If you know the greatest commandment, what God has told, the greatest commandment that is written is that you need to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with your entire being. And the same way how you love God, you need to love your neighbor. That is your family, your friends, your neighbors who stay beside you, the poor, okay? So you need to be loving. You need to love, okay? If you see God, he loved us so much, okay? And out of love, he created us. So in a similar way, we need to love God. We need to love our neighbors. We need to love our friends. We need to even love our enemies. Someone who has not done good to us. Someone who has ill-treated us. Someone who teases us. We need to love even that person. Okay? The second thing over here is, okay? It is E. You need to be eager to pray. Okay? The church teaches us to pray. Okay. Now in this period of lockdown, I believe everyone might be praying at home with their families, have got a lot of time. Okay. In this lockdown, there was no work. Your mama, dada was there with you at home and you had sufficient time to spend in prayer. Okay. So you need to pray. Okay. You need to pray. And this is very important in our Christian life. You need to pray. The third thing over here is you need to serve the poor. Okay. Now, since this lockdown has happened, we see there's a lot of problems that are happening. Okay. Not just in other countries that we see in the TV, but in our own neighborhood where we stay. There are people around who do not have food to eat. There are people around who do not have clothes to wear. There are people around who do not have mobile phones to attend their school lectures. Okay. A lot of problems are there, but we need to see how can we help? How can we serve the poor, the people who do not have? Okay. So we need to reach out to the poor. Okay. And when we reach out to the poor, if you remember, I said that you need to love your neighbor. It also means you need to love the poor. So reaching out to poor, you need to give something to the poor, maybe something to eat, something to drink, something to wear, whatever in your own way. Okay. In your own way, whatever you can, maybe one small vada pav to some beggar over there. Okay. Maybe a glass of juice to someone over there. So it is God becomes happy when he sees you serving the poor. Okay. And the fourth one over here, that is T, okay? You need to offer your talents and your gifts, okay? And I believe so many of you all sitting over here and listening are gifted, okay? You'll have the gift of drawing. You'll have the gift of singing. You'll have the gift of dancing. You'll have the gift of doing various other things, okay? Can you offer that gift and that talent to God? Okay. Can you offer that gift and that talent to God? And when you use these gifts, these talents, okay, unto God, you make God happy. You know, one more thing when you use your gift and your talent is you're helping God, okay? You're helping God to build his church. You're helping people know about God, okay? You're helping people know how much God loves us. So it is very important for you to use your gifts and your talents to God, okay, for God. So the thing over here is the four things that I gave you, okay? B-E-S-T. Can we just read it once again? So B stands for be loving. Remember the greatest commandment, okay? That is love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with your entire being, and love your neighbor as yourself. Then E, okay, that is eager to pray, okay? You need to pray. When you pray, you speak with God, you communicate with God, okay? And God wants to listen to you. He wants to answer your prayer, okay? B-E, now S, what is S? Serve the poor. We see a lot of, now also we see a lot of poor people around us, people who are in need. Go and serve them, okay? And T, that is talents. Use your gifts and your talents for God. That will make God God happy. That will also help others in knowing God through you. Okay? And the final thing over here is be the best offering. Okay? If you see the saints, okay, tomorrow we are celebrating a wonderful feast. Of which saint? Can anyone type? Anyone knows which saints feast are we celebrating tomorrow? Quickly. One very famous saint. Okay. So we are celebrating the feast of Don Bosco tomorrow. So he is a saint who loves young children like you and me. Okay. He loves young children like you and me. So we are celebrating his feast tomorrow. And what he says, no, you do everything in life, okay? You want to enjoy, you enjoy. But in whatever you do, you should not sin, okay? In whatever you do, you should not sin, okay? So, dear children, let us offer ourselves as the best offering unto God. And I believe that you will become a saint. When you offer this best offering, you will become a saint. If you see the life of every saint, each saint has done something best. Each saint has offered best, okay? And more importantly, they have offered their lives, okay, to God. They have offered the best of their lives unto God. Praise the Lord. God is good and all the time. So let us just close our eyes. Let us just close our eyes, keep ourselves calm. And even as our eyes are closed, okay, what is that one thing that you are picking up from today? What is that one thing? B-E-S-T. Okay. You need to offer your best unto God. What is that one thing that you are picking up? God loves you as you are. And he also wants you to love him. And when you love him, when you pray unto him, when you serve the poor, when you use your talents, you are making the best use of yourself. And you're offering yourself unto God. So even as our eyes are closed, let us offer ourselves unto God. He loves you and me. He knows that it is difficult at times. He knows our weakness. He knows our pain. He knows when we are crying. He knows our struggle. Sometimes we are not able to study. We study, we keep reading, but it does not go in our head. God knows each one of us. He loves you. And can we love him back? Can we offer him the best? That is a question that we need to answer. That is a question that we need to ask ourselves. And let us pray and let us ask the Lord. Lord, we need your help. We are here just offering our lives unto you the way we are. We want to make ourselves the best version that you want us to be. And even as we sing this song, just open your hands in front of us. Open your hands. And when you open your hands, ask the Lord, Lord, you come and help me, that I may be the best offering. And definitely he will come and help you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. He is there beside you. He is there in you. Hearts, let us just thank Jesus and let us experience that Jesus is coming in us and is helping us. And let us quieten our hearts and let us feel his presence. His wonderful presence. And this is what Jesus wants you to remember always, okay? He wants you to remember that he is by your side. He is not going to leave you. He is not going to forsake you. He is there with you. And this is the promise that you need to keep in your heart. Okay? This is the promise that you need to keep in your heart, that God is with you. He He is helping you. And let us all together say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
And thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Let us give a mighty hand unto God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. Once again, we'll just have a look at the points that Aldo had given, this BEST. I just want to show that once again. And one task you have, all of you have, is if you can, if it's possible, then take a screenshot of this slide. Now you can see this particular thing. Just take a screenshot of this. And the task that you have is to put this into practice for the next entire week, because we are meeting only on the 6th of February again. 6th of February, we are meeting again for the prayer meeting. And as we meet for the prayer meeting, you have to practice this, you know, BEST. You have to practice this entire thing. And we will ask you, you know, when we meet on the 6th of February, we will ask you again whether you have put this into practice or not. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Will you do that, children? Very simple. Be loving. You can be loving wherever you are, at your house or maybe in the society, wherever you are. E for eager to pray. That we have to pray, you know, even if it's like 5 minutes, it is okay. For 5 minutes, we can pray. S for serve the poor. That means we'll just give something to the poor. Maybe the people who are coming to your house to work, household work, we can give it to them, or maybe the one who you can see. And the last is using your talent and gift, which could be anything. Use it for the glory of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So now we will take a final song. And as we take the final song, Sarah and Carol will lead us into this last song. You know, do the actions with them. It's a very simple song, Every Move I Make, and they will do the actions and sing for us.
Every move I make, I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. Every step I take, I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you.
One more time.
Every move I make, I'm making you. You make me move, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you. I take in you. You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I'm breathing you.
Waves of mercy, waves of grace. Everywhere I look, I see your face. Your love has captured me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be?
Sing it.
me. Oh my God, this love, how can it be?
And all the time.
God is good.
And all God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. Amen.